Hello, everybody. We finally know. We have the answer to the big question of the offseason. What is Giannis Antetokounmpo going to do? According to Shams Charania of The Athletic, he has indeed elected to stay with the Milwaukee Bucks, signing a new five-year deal with them, which is great. Big win for the city of Milwaukee and all Bucks fans. But of course, well, we want to know, what does it mean for the Lakers? That's right. This does impact your Los Angeles Lakers. And here at Lakers Nation, we look at everything through purple and gold lenses. So let's dive in. But first, quick reminder, do subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. All right. So Giannis stays with the Milwaukee Bucks. That means that there's one less free agent out on the market in 2021. So for a Lakers team that was for a while rumored to be potentially hoarding cap space in 2021, and then they gave up that plan this offseason, they gave a three-year deal to Kentavious Caldwell-Pope, new long-term contracts to LeBron James and Anthony Davis. Clearly, they didn't cost themselves anything, assuming the plan was always for Giannis to come back to the Milwaukee Bucks. They didn't cost themselves a shot at Giannis Antetokounmpo by signing those deals. So maybe that's a little bit of a sigh of relief there. There could also be repercussions for Kostas Antetokounmpo, who currently has a two-way contract with the Los Angeles Lakers. Now, I've always maintained that Kostas has merit of his own as a player, and it's not just that the Lakers wanted him around to lure his brother, but that's certainly a perk of having him on the roster. So if there was anything holding them back from perhaps moving on from Kostas Antetokounmpo, maybe that reluctance is gone now that Giannis is off the market. Again, though, Kostas has his own merit as a player, so it would not surprise me in the least to see him stick around. But I'm just saying, if that in any way, that relationship with Giannis or that potential to bring in Giannis was a reason to keep him around, that is now gone. Now, for the Lakers, it also means their cap space for 2021 that they've spent, not as big of a deal. There's not that many free agents that are out there on the market. There's still a few. I mean, look, Kawhi Leonard is still potentially out there. You've got some other guys, Rudy Gobert, maybe a Mike Conley. Players like that could still be on the market in 2021. But just as the Lakers are going to notice that the 2021 free agent class has dried up quite a bit now that Paul George is off the market, LeBron James, Anthony Davis, Giannis Antetokounmpo, all these guys are already on new deals, so too will other teams around the NBA. There is going to be a ripple effect, and that can absolutely impact the Lakers. I mean, just look at the Miami Heat, who the Lakers played in last year's NBA Finals. They are one of the teams that has been long rumored to be saving cap space for 2021 to try to bring Giannis to South Beach. And obviously that is no longer going to happen. So does that mean the Miami Heat might now get more aggressive in James Harden trade talks? What will they do? They're going to pivot to something else. The same could be said for the Dallas Mavericks and basically any other team that had their eyes on Giannis Antetokounmpo. Yes, there are other free agents that are still out there in 2021, but he was the big fish. So might they now move to plan B? We're going to see teams around the NBA behave differently now that this major domino has fallen. Again, maybe we're going to see the James Harden trade talks pick up. Maybe there's going to be other trade discussions that come along as teams look to improve and perhaps challenge the Lakers, now knowing that they can't find that piece in the offseason of 2021. They're going to look for alternative ways to do that. It also could be a good thing for the Lakers because, yes, it means the Bucks will be formidable moving forward for the foreseeable future, but it also means that Giannis isn't going to go create a super team in Miami with Jimmy Butler or in Dallas with Luka Doncic. There could have been some very, very deadly teams created had Giannis jumped ship. So this actually could help the Lakers by keeping Giannis in Milwaukee where he doesn't have a superstar running mate. But the bottom line is the Lakers have the roster. The Lakers like their roster a lot. The chance to land Giannis Antetokounmpo next offseason was always more of a long shot, more of a pie-in-the-sky type scenario than anything else, so I don't think they really lost a lot here. But the really interesting thing for the Lakers will be, how do other teams around the NBA respond? Because I'll tell you what, there's a lot of teams out there that aren't looking at the Lakers as this unbeatable juggernaut and want to go and take a shot at them. And now that they don't have to worry about preserving cap space for Giannis in 2021, they're probably going to get more aggressive making moves so that they can challenge the Los Angeles Lakers. But let me know what you guys think. What do you think the fallout is going to be from Giannis Antetokounmpo picking the Milwaukee Bucks? Give me your thoughts in the comments down below. And don't forget, follow Lakers Nation across social media at Lakers Nation on Twitter and Facebook, at Lakers Nation Official on Instagram. And if you want to follow me, you can find me at Trevor_Lane on Twitter, at Trevor Lane NBA on Instagram. Till next time, stay safe and see ya.